Hello everyone and welcome back to the Universim, where they have just applied a hotfix to the Paragon update, and I am interested to know what this hotfix entails. So let's go ahead and try and create another thriving civilization, shall we? Let's see, what could they have possibly fixed? Could they have fixed the farming? Could they have balanced a little bit of stuff? Let's see if we can find out what they fixed. The hotfix came out, I'm not even really sure when it did. I kind of forgot about the game for a little bit, and then I was like, oh shoot, I need to check and see if there's any updates. I'm pretty sure there isn't, but maybe there is, and so far there actually was an update. Let's look and see if we can find a good place. I like this place right here. In between these two bundles of water here. Well, I don't think you call water bundles, but you know. There are two batches of water. There's actually a place over here too, which isn't too shabby. But it doesn't have as much water. You could plop it down right here and use this and this. Something to be said for that, since... yeah, we might as well. Just for the fact that... there is no way that we're ever going to get through all this water anyway. Alright, so they're immediately going and chopping and picking rocks. I still don't understand why they do this. You can't click on this to see how full it is. It looks really full, but apparently they don't think it's full. They're not even building a stone hut. Like, why are they gathering resources if they plan on building nothing? That is one thing I do not understand. Perhaps it is a bug. I do not know. But we will place a pump over here. First thing to build. Remember, we're still going to try and treat our nuggets like a source of currency. I noticed my resolution in this game is horrible too, because this bar is like huge, whereas everybody else that plays it has this bar like take up to here or something. It's ridiculous. I think it looks better big like this, because it fills out the whole entire thing. It just looks better, whereas theirs just has a bunch of dead space. So in a way, it looks better. The game seems to be playing more fluidly, maybe? I don't know, I could be wrong. They seem to work a lot faster, maybe? I don't know, I'm kinda confused. One of the things I hate is why are they still gathering resources when the building can be built? See, look, watch, they're gonna waste these resources. Oh wait, no they're not. They just broke the stuff and then went to go build. Huh. Maybe that's something they changed, because I think they used to just take the resources and completely waste them. Alright, so not so bad, not so bad. They're trying to build a hut over there, okay. Good. Water pump is beautiful and done. They're having a date, that's wonderful. You guys... are you going to be able to have a kid? I don't think so. You haven't built your house. You might want to prioritize that over a date. Just so you know. I've agreed to begin production on new nuggets. Okay, maybe that's what it says when they don't have a house. They're like, okay, we have agreed to have sex, but we need a house first. The house will already have water. Apparently they can have sex in a house that doesn't have water. I don't know. Do houses really need water? Who knows? But I am really, really hoping that they balanced all the things that were broken just to the point where you couldn't have a thriving civilization. They didn't have to balance everything, just fix all the things that were broken to the point where you couldn't have a thriving civilization. Once that's good, we're good to go. I'm excited to try the farm out to see if maybe it works. Sure hope so. And we'll probably place a fisher down, but I think we'll go ahead and wait just a little bit, let them finish their house first. Because it is very important. He's already started building it. I think one thing that they do need to do in the coding is they need to let Nuggets know faster that the resources are already there. See, if she would have known in a split second that she was the one to deliver the last of the resources, they both could have just been building this, whereas she thought she had to go get more... What was that? Stone? Wood? I'm not really sure. So that's one thing they would need to update, is just make it so that if a Nugget is bringing the last of the resources, that Nugget understands there's no more resources needed for the stone hut. What are you guys doing? Why are you standing around doing nothing? You agreed to make babies, so why are you not making babies? Makes no sense. But anyway, let's go ahead and plop down a well so they can have a bit of water. That way they won't do nothing. Please don't tell me. Don't even tell me. Are you kidding me? They are. They're going to chop rocks. What is wrong with these rocks over here? Oh, wait. Maybe that is one that needs to be chopped? I don't know. It doesn't look like... Well, no, it looks like those. Which those look already mined. I don't understand. I don't know if maybe they decide to prioritize raw resources if they're too close to the center. Maybe it's true. Maybe all these trees are just too close, so they're like, we don't want to use this wood because we actually want to kind of clear the land out so you can place buildings and we can place stone huts and stuff. And if so, that's rather brilliant, actually. There they go. Now they're going on a date or going to actually just make love. Oh, they're just going to date right outside their house. That's fine. What are you doing? Oh, you're building, bringing resources to this. You're already building this. That's great. She's going to build it. It seems like they prioritize a lot better, maybe? I'm not 100% sure. Hey, they just formed a family. So, is that what the dating is all about? Like, now it forms families and they just mate whenever they want, kind of thing? Or at certain times? Yeah, there's the mating. So now we'll have some babies coming. That's good. He did build the well, which is fantastic. We gotta keep an eye on the degradation. Oh, this seems like it's getting not too bad. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, there we go. You can just barely click on the stone hut. Yeah, that might have been something they took down. Because that was one of my suggestions, was that the building degradation was just too fast. I'm hoping, like, that they took all, or, I mean, I'm even assuming that they even saw my video, which they probably didn't. My video gets, like, what, 10% of normal people doing these videos? 10% of the amount of views, I'd say? Which I guess makes sense, because I probably have less than 10% of their subscribers, because my subscribers just don't ever move. I don't know why. I think it might be something broken or like other people are flying up in subscribers even if they're tiny channels. And I don't understand. Unless they're doing sub for sub. And if so, I mean, I guess more luck to them because my sub for sub adventure was terrible. And it ended up crippling my channel to the point where I just don't get subscribers anymore. Which is pretty terrible, but, you know, I'm not doing this for subscribers. I'm doing this just to share it for people. And I really want people to find the videos, because then maybe a person that didn't even know this game existed, they could maybe find it and be like, wow, this game looks pretty cool. And I'll be like, yeah, it is pretty cool. I mean, that's a little expensive right now. I mean, you'd have to shell out a lot of money for just an alpha. I was okay with it because, honestly, I love these kind of games. This is so great of a game. Like, I'm currently addicted to Euro Truck Simulator 2, which is another game where not very much happens, but it's very relaxing to, you know, simulate driving a truck all over Europe. I have all of the DLC for it, so I also have, like, Scandinavia and the Czech Republic and stuff like that. It's huge! It's gigantic, that game. I can't believe it. I would probably never do an LP of it though, because the whole idea of it is driving a truck in not real time, but it does take a long time. Like 5 hour drives take what, maybe a half hour, 45 minutes to actually drive it in real time. It's pretty crazy. And the whole idea is to just build a huge trucking empire. You start out with nothing, not even your own truck. You just get to, do crazy stuff. And these are the kind of games that I really love. These casual games where you don't really have to do that much. Like, I'm even getting pissed off at Warlock because, what happened in the last episode, my hero just died in one hit due to that stupidly overpowered golden dragon. Which is weird because I've killed a golden dragon before. I think this guy is just glitched. And then, not to mention the glitch that happened to him. I'm okay with automatically fighting an enemy if you click in the darkness or something. I mean, I don't really like it, but I understand. But the thing is, I need to fight the enemy. What happened is I walked, and then the enemy immediately hit me, so they got a free hit without me retaliating. And then I hit them, and they hit me back again. So they got double hits that turn, which is bullshit. Okay, so we're gonna assign a fisher. Let's go with Chumbu here. Mating, okay. So it must be in there, okay. That's understandable. And then I want to say that maybe an eatery would be okay now. Let's try it. We'll try putting it over here, probably. This way it won't be too close to the well, but it will still be pretty close to the fishery. Or, is that what the, no, fisher pier. I mean, we might as well just call him a fishery. Doesn't really matter. What is this guy doing? What are you doing? Why do you have a little staff, dude? Are you going to harvest food? Is that what you look like when you go to harvest food? Yeah, going to gather food. Do you really need a cane to gather food? That is kind of strange. But then again, I guess, how are you going to show them gathering food? I mean, if I had the choice, I would probably give them like a basket in their hand or something so they can go like pick berries or melons or something. It makes more sense than a cane. Seems like they're going to tend some sheep or something. Ooh! Ooh, I wonder if that's going to be a thing in this game. Like domesticating wild animals? Like, I'm watching Quill 18 play RimWorld, and he's like domesticating wild animals and hunting wild animals and stuff, and I'm like, whoa. I wonder if that's going to be a thing in Universim. That would be really cool. Though I hope raids won't be a thing in Universim, unless maybe you put that on as an option. I would probably always leave it off though, because I don't really want it to be a defense game. I want it to be a game about expanding and keeping your people alive. Oh, look at that. She is fishing. She is going for it. How many fish are you going to catch? That's one thing I wonder if they fixed as well, if they might have brought the fish cap back up to 6. I do not know. Or maybe 5, because they can carry 5 stuff. No, it's still 3. Okay. All right, that's not a change that I am aware of. Okay. It does seem like they still love to just leave all their garbage everywhere. Look at all these piles of wood. Not even being used. At all. Even though this building could use. Well, I can't use more wood anymore. Why are you chopping trees if you don't need wood? Why are you doing this? I don't understand. This building clearly needs 5 stone. Why is everyone chopping trees? I guess maybe they're just doing it just to do it? See, she's bringing the stone. I think. Yeah, she brought the stone, so now the building's ready to be made. And see, she didn't start making the building. It doesn't happen instantaneously, but these guys understand. They got the message. They're like, oh, hey, Building's ready. She thinks it still needs stone. This is why we end up with tons of piles of resources everywhere. And even if you build a warehouse, it doesn't really make a difference because they just don't grab from the warehouse. Ever, or they don't prioritize it. Unless they do now, I'm not 100% sure. But we'll have to find out. Let's see what happens. I might do a warehouse just to get some of these resources out of the way so I can plop a hospital down right there on the right side of the screen. It's not a bad idea. Now I'm not gonna try and manage my nuggets like a currency as much as I did before. I was just trying to see if it actually did work, and we got ourselves up to like 10 nuggets or something. We're gonna go a little bit better this time. This way, if you think about it, we have a cook, we have a fisher, and we have nobody else that has a job. Okay, that's 75%. That still seems really quite decent. 67%, that's kinda terrible. 76%, that's pretty bad too. 93%. 99%, okay. I don't know why this one is degrading so badly, like 67%. This was the first building ever made. I don't understand why it's not degraded all the way, if that's even a word. It sounds like it's supposed to be a word, so I'm just gonna press it. Let's go ahead and build a warehouse. And we're gonna put it right about... If I put it here, does it take away the thing? Let me see. It doesn't. Is that something new, or does it only take away raw resources? I don't remember. I do not remember. We're getting some food, though. I am noticing that. Where is everybody? Where in the hell did they go? Oh, there's someone. Oh, I think they're going off to, like, gather food? What the hell do you have? You have, like, a basket. What is that? Delivering resources. It's food. Oh, so... I guess they have a basket on the way back, but they have a cane. I mean, maybe it makes sense. Maybe the cane is a walking stick. Maybe they know, whoa, man, I gotta go really far away to, you know, get the food. Jeez, what are they doing? Like, getting so much food. Well, that's not a change that they made. The natural resources do not grow still. There's some mating happening, okay. See, one of the problems with the AI, like I said, is that they just wander off too far. What it needs to be is... Their AI needs to be a proximity to this, yes, but it needs to take into account water where they cannot walk. It needs to, you know, take into account that, hey, things that are over here, they may seem closer in a straight line, but you gotta think that they actually have to walk all the way around the water. So one of these days, I'm pretty sure they'll update the AI to do that. Because what the hell is this guy doing? Going to mine stone. Oh, he's going to mine this stone. Okay, that's fine. That makes sense. This is all close proximity. But once these stones are gone, like, where are they gonna go? I would think they should go up here, get these little bits of stones, because it's on this side of the river. Or big lake, whatever this thing is. I guess it's not really a river. That would be nice if they added rivers in this too. That would be really good. What are you doing? Oh, somebody's fishing. She's still fishing. Oh, that might be something they changed too. Maybe the... Yeah, they seem like they don't age as fast now, maybe. Because wasn't I having people die like the very first year? I'm hoping they change the winter. Like, I am just praying they change the winter. It was way too long and way too harsh. And I mean, the only penalty you get in winter is the fact that you can't use your fisher. And there's no way you're going to have a farm by the first time. Oh, look at this. We got 5 meals. We got 14 raw food. Hopefully they're still storing a whole lot in the eatery. That's not good. Let me check, take a look at my recording real quick. 20 minutes. Okay, it's already 20 minutes in. Don't have an injury yet, so maybe that's something they nerfed a little bit, which I would not be complaining about. I think it did need to be nerfed a bit. The injuries were just too much. Fishing season is closed, so there is still that garbage fishing season is closed. Now, are the fishers smart enough yet? Did they balance the fishers to make it so that they won't just sit here in an animation loop? That's one thing I do want to check. Because if so, that would be great if they just become normal nuggets when they can't fish. And then they go back to being fishers as soon as fisher season opens. That's great. Oh, there's an injury. Okay. That is fine. Why is this not getting done? Jeez. Hurry up, guys. Like, finish that warehouse, please. What are you doing? You are going to eat. That is fantastic. There should be another way of them curing injuries, too. Like, just a hospital? It's not enough. And maybe there should be, like, a nurse at the hospital that can help boost their. Or maybe what the nurse could do is stop their injuries or slow their decay of their injury while they're in the hospital. Now, what are you gonna do? You're going home? Okay, that's good. Please do not get stuck in the fissure. Don't do it. You better go home. I think the home with the heart means that they're going to have sex. I think. I think that's what it means. They're going to make baby nuggets. Right? Yes, they're mating. That's, you know, layman's terms, mating. Ah, somebody grew up into a big nugget. Good. We need to get a hospital up, so I want this warehouse to be finished. So let's go ahead and do that. We also need an engineer's because I'm pretty sure that these buildings are looking. I mean, they're not too bad. Little under 50% is not too bad. Now, see, I don't want them to take my complaining about the winter as a thing where they're like, oh, well, we'll have 5 second winters. No, winter can be there. I'm fine with that. Just don't make it so excruciatingly long. So we're gonna go ahead and build a hospital because we do need one. Let's make sure the entrance is attainable. Ooh, careful. I want to get this as close without ruining that tree. There we go. Perfect. Look at that. Right up to those herbs. And I think there was another one around here. I thought there was. Well, I mean, there's this one. It might be able to go get. Maybe the witch doctors are smarter now. Maybe they just know exactly what to do. You better be going for drink. Why are you delivering resources when you're super thirsty? Maybe it's because they can't drop them. They should be able to drop resources and then be able to pick it back up. There you go. You're going to drink. The well has some drink. Are you seriously not going to the well? Oh, he might be going to the eatery. That makes sense. Okay. Okay, what are you doing here? You're not stuck in an animation loop. What are you doing? You're gutting. Oh. Okay, that's something that could be done at the winter. Now, please don't tell me you're stuck. Yep, she's stuck in an animation loop. God damn it. Well, we knew it wouldn't work. I was hoping for the best, but yeah, it doesn't work. I'm sure that's something they will address in the future because that nugget is worthless in the winter. You have to tell them to stop being fishers, and I'm pretty sure that's not something that they want you to have to micromanage. This person is going to die of their injuries. Please, build the hospital faster. Prioritize. We have a bunch of laborers. I mean, literally, there's only one person employed right now. Just one. That's it. The injuries take their health down far too much. Far too quickly. Let's see if maybe they boosted the witch doctor. If I can even get a witch doctor, like... Hospitals take a lot of resources. It takes hours to build. Because all the nuggets, what they have to do is they have to gather raw resources. They cannot use these resources on the ground. Look at all this wood. Just sitting here. It could literally be hauled over to the hospital, and that would probably be all the wood the hospital needs. They don't need to chop trees. It takes more time. There's stuff in the warehouse here. There's even food. Okay, that's fine. I'm okay with that, I guess. Oh, good. Another person injured themselves. I didn't even get the message, I don't think. So apparently that's not a hotfix that they did anything with, unfortunately. Oh, there's the message. A little late. What? Three injuries? Are you freaking kidding me? I've been playing for like 25 minutes and I have three injuries on my hands. Not to mention, one of them is pretty close to dying, one of them is a half health, and this other one is pretty good. So freaking help me if they don't prioritize the ones that are at lower health before these ones that could deal with their injuries a bit longer. Oh, I am going to be pissed. Because that is something that should be in the game right now. If you're gonna have injuries, and apparently copious amounts of injuries, I mean, I have 8 adults and 3 are injured. That's nearly half the adults injured in the first 25 minutes. And these 3 injuries happen within 5 minutes of each other. That is ridiculous. And I don't know how they're gonna deal with this. Like, are you guys ever gonna build this stupid hospital? Ever? Just ever? And then what in the hell do you do if, like, everyone's injured? You would never be able to have a witch doctor because the witch doctor would be injured themselves and then they would just end up dying. Like, I don't know how they haven't figured out these little catch-22 things. It seems so simple, so logical to figure out. I don't know how you would work around it, of course, but the working out and figuring out what's going on with it, it seems so logical. It's like if you have a witch doctor that's injured, obviously can't heal itself, which makes no sense, because I'm pretty sure that doctors can, like, give themselves prescriptions or something. But, like I was saying, if they have this many freaking injuries, there has to be something to do with it. Okay, the stone hut's in bad condition, so it's definitely going to be a good idea to get some engineers now. Hopefully it won't break. Let's go ahead and put this right about there. That looks pretty good. Please, build the hospital faster. It's almost done. But this person is, like, totally dead. Although they do have good food and good water, which is definitely better than last time. I gotta say. Now, can we please have a good witch doctor? It would be so nice if you could tell who's injured here. I guess I'm just gonna pick Aha and hope they're not injured. What I don't understand is if they're gonna play around with the injury system this much, what they need to do is open these other beds. Forget the upgrades, you don't have upgrades yet. Just open the other beds. Work them in so that we can get more people in here so that they can get healed. We have to have some way of dealing with this copious amounts of injuries. And it takes so long to make medicines. Because one, you have to go for the herbs, then you have to make the medicine, and I think you only get like one herb. Look, every one of these only has one herb. So this guy is probably gonna die. Unfortunately. But maybe not. Like I said, he's still really good with hunger, really good with thirst. And she's actually pretty good with it too. She's getting a little hungry, but I think she'll be okay. Where's that other injured person? Over here? Are you the injured one? I don't really know. I think so, probably. Your health is really low. Yes, they're all really good with food and water. Wait, the winter's over? Well, maybe they did make the winter a little less harsh. That's nice. Let's get back to fishing. I don't know if that person's injured. Like, that is information that you need. So I think what they should do on that assigning page, we'll just look at this one because I can't do an assigning again. But on the assigning page, put like a little injury icon here on the nugget so you can know, hey, this person's injured. I might not want to put them in this spot. I'm just spitballing here. Engineers almost built, which is really good because we need that really soon. So please prioritize this. Oh, I think she's bringing the last little bit. Wait, no, never mind. Stone hut is in bad condition. That's fine. That's fine. Just don't collapse, okay? 21%, that's fine. 30%. So that 30%, that's when it warns you that it's in bad condition. I think that's okay. Maybe they could do a little better, like 35%. Give you a little bit more time to build an engineers. Or maybe it would be depending upon whether you have an engineer slash an engineer building. Maybe, I don't know. Come on, people, please prioritize this plox so that we can get this going. So far, this is okay. As you can tell, we're low on raw food, of course. But that's not really a real problem. Are you? You're sailing. Okay, good. So he's not injured. That's fantastic. He's just doing it. He just caught three fish already. Just like that. I just made him a fisher. He is on top of this. I trust him almost fully. Well, what's going on? Warehouse doesn't have enough water to function. Ooh, that's a bad thing. Let's go ahead and build another water pump. That is a dumb looking water pump. It's gonna be all sideways, but whatever. Oh God, is that a stone hut? Yes, it is. Man, they're expanding quite a bit. I don't think this really matters that it doesn't have enough water to function. I really don't think it matters. Whoa, look at the healing! Look at how much faster the healing happens when your nuggets aren't freaking starving and thirsting to death. Look at that. Their needs are still really good. Even hers is still really good. She's been sitting there forever. Okay. So that might be a change. Where is that other injured person? I wanted to keep an eye on them. I have no idea. Oh, there they are. Their health is looking a little bad. But she should be able to go to the hospital next. I really wish there was another one here. So maybe that person could go for herbs. And like the normal witch doctor would get the potions going or the medicine or whatnot. Because it just takes too long. Like, people just have to sit here waiting while he goes and collects herbs. And now it's really going to be a problem because there's nowhere to go for herbs. That's going to be a huge problem. All right, engineers is up and running. Perfect. Let's get at least one engineer. Chumbu, you used to be the fisherman, I believe. You will now be an engineer. We need to get these buildings repaired like ASAP. Look at that, 12%, 20%. Yeah, we gotta get these buildings repaired. Where are you? Building? Where are you? Oh, you're building the stone hut. That's beautiful. Now, does that mean that she's automatically already an engineer? Let me see her real quick. Oh. Hey, how come I can't click you? There we go. Yeah, she's automatically an engineer, which means she might automatically already be doing the building bonus. I'm not really sure. Now you gotta be an engineer. There you go. She's going for it. She's got the little wood, the 2x4 in her hand. Now, does that mean you can immediately repair, or do you have to go to the engineer's hut? Yeah, you have to go to the engineer's hut first. That's fine, I understand. This is looking a little critical, though. I hope you repair this first. Please. Please tell me they fix this. Come on. Don't let me down. Don't you do it. She's going for the well. Are you kidding me? Why? I can't prioritize repairs. Okay, devs, do you see this? My well is under 50%. Yes, it does need repairs, of course, but look at this. There's a building that is so close to collapsing. That it's not gonna get repaired. I have to get another engineer. She's just too stupid. They have to fix this. Like, this is critically bad. All they do is they repair any building that is close to the engineer hut. They don't look at these symbols. Why is this not a thing by now? If you're going to introduce building degradation, the engineers have to be able to prioritize the ones that are about to fall apart. This is critical. This is something that needs to be fixed ASAP, like yesterday. Like, this needed to be fixed in the Paragon update. Please. Please, somebody repair this before it falls apart. It's at 5%. Someone has to repair it. It's so close to the engineering hut. It has to be repaired. Please. Please. Yes. Oh my god, he's repairing it. Thank the Lord. Holy god. They're never gonna repair this either. It's gonna collapse. It's at 12% now. So, unfortunately, the building degradation, it seems to just go up over time. Would be what I feel like it's doing. They do seem to do a better job of taking care of their needs, maybe? She is a little thirsty. She is getting healed. Unfortunately, he didn't heal this person that was waiting before her. Why? I don't understand why. I almost feel like you have to have a farm that's gonna get herbs now. I think we put our farm right about here. I know it's going to take away trees, but I don't really care. I need it to be close to the hospital. Because we're going to grow herbs and we're going to grow food here as long as it works. Oh my god, the water pumps are in bad condition. Would you please? What are you doing? Why did it take so long to repair? Did you see that? He was still repairing this stone hut. Why does it have to take like 2%? Couldn't it take like 5%? They're engineers, for Christ's sake. Couldn't they get better as they repair? Of course, go and repair that eatery because it's close and it's not even needing to be repaired. Of course, why not? Why repair this thing that's just about to collapse? 7%, 29%? Just leave them. They'll collapse. Who cares? Nobody cares. It's just somebody's house, and they'll just be, you know, out on the street, homeless. That's fine. They'll be fine with that. Yeah, you totally repair that eatery. That totally doesn't need repairing. So, devs, if you do see this video, which I doubt you will, but if you do, by some miracle, please... This needs to be the next change, and this needs to be in the Paragon update. Like, this needs to be done ASAP. That these dumb fucking dumb engineers need to know that they need to repair these buildings ASAP. They won't do it. I cannot prioritize repairs. Why are they so stupid? Are they just blind to these buildings because it's not close enough to the engineer's hut? Do I literally need like 80 engineer's huts all over here so that they can repair the two buildings that are closest to them? That's ridiculous. Please. Please, dear God, tell me you're going to repair that because it's just about to die. 3%. Please. Oh my God. Oh my God. Whew. That's when you have a heart attack right there. When you think one of your houses is gonna be destroyed. And it almost happened too. Why are people injuring themselves so much? Can you guys not injure yourselves? Okay, another thing also as well. This guy should not be going to the hospital. Just because they're injured should not mean that they go directly to the hospital. What they should do is they should take care of their needs first. See how he's hungry? Where's my witch doctor? He's eating. These guys are not recovering. Like, it says they're recovering in the hospital, but they're not recovering. They cannot, and I repeat, they cannot recover without a witch doctor at all. It's not possible. So, they need to be able to get up out of the hospital and go and feed themselves in water and everything because their needs are still decaying. See? This is still decaying. He is hungry, and he could die. I wonder if there's an award for being the most hungry and not dying. Well, I don't know. I guess you're gonna find out, dude, because you're the most hungry, and you're actually probably going to die. Because, like I said, it's not gonna work. Let's see if the farms actually work. I don't know if they do. Let's find out. We don't really need food right now. I feel like food is probably not super necessary. Oh, great. Of course. Why wouldn't all the herbs be not in the... fuck it. Let's just put food. What? Yes. Let me see here. Is there something else here? No, they took away... No, they put the juicy acorn in the mountain. Thank you, devs. I'm so glad that the grassland cannot create herbs. And I'm so very glad that the mountain can create two different herbs. That's good balance. Good job. Alright, so I'm gonna try doing this. Apparently we can't have herbs. I mean, if we do, they have to take forever to grow because it's a huge penalty if they're not in their biome. My God, you take forever. Why does everything take forever? What is with these devs in 2%? Everything goes up 2% at a time, except for the healing, of course. If that went up 2% at a time, that would actually be helpful. What are you doing, Witch Doctor? Oh, he's going home. Of course. I mean, why heal your patients? You don't even need to go home! Your rest is like 50%. Your energy is like at 50%. What the fuck, dude? I don't understand. Why would you go home? Can't you just heal another person? Can't you like see that they're dying on your beds? Please tell me you're gonna get to this water pump. Are they literally never gonna be able to fix this water pump? Because all these buildings are gonna degrade over time? They're just going to be like, oh, this building's like 2% degraded. Let's go ahead and fix that. God, they're fucking retarded. So fucking retarded. Like, we're going to lose this water pump easily. Because see, now she's going to go to the engineer's hut. The engineer's hut is going to be like, oh, look, the well needs some repairs. It's 20%. Wait, is that an engineer? Is that my other engineer? Please. Please tell me you're repairing that. Do it. Yes! But see, this isn't a thing that... Wait, are you repairing that 1% at a time? Are you fucking kidding me? 1% at a time? Why? I don't know. I thought it was 2% at a time. Well, apparently that's going to take like a half hour to repair. This is ridiculous. Like I said, they still have a lot of balancing to do. I'm really hoping the farm actually works, though. I never got to show you guys that it didn't work because I couldn't make it. Why did he plant already? This is not spring, buddy. Are they just waiting to grow? Wait, can they just grow anytime they want now? If so, that's new. Oh, excuse me. That's new, and I kind of am okay with that change. I like that a lot, actually. Gosh, and even building another hospital wouldn't be helpful because where are you going to get the herbs? I mean, I could plant herbs, but like I said, it's going to be difficult to grow. As soon as this guy gets out of the hospital, he better go eat. I mean, the eatery's right here, dude. It's like right next door. You better go eat. I'm gonna be whooping your butt if you don't go eat. I better see that little food icon above your head. Go on. You know you want to. Yeah, that's right. He's gone. What? What? He was going to eat, and now he's going to mine stone. Why? Why? Is it that there's no food? No food that's accessible? Oh, yeah, of course. That's the problem. There's no food that's accessible. Because, of course, the fucking kitchen hogging all the food, even though it doesn't need to. Hogging all the food so nobody can eat raw food. I hate these fucking goddamn kitchens. I hate them so much. I don't understand why they feel the need to hog all the food. This way, if this one table that can seat 2 nuggets, when I have 20 nuggets now, so if that one table is full, fucking nobody can eat until that one table is done being full. This is ridiculous. Ridiculous. There is absolutely no reason this should be happening at all. In any way, shape, or form, should this ever be happening. Because you know what's going to happen? Now we'll have raw food from the farm, as long as it works. And then the kitchen's going to take it all and stock it all. I just don't understand. How is this a good idea? That's what I just want the devs to, like, answer us. How is it a good idea that the kitchen takes all of the raw food? I understand that it's cooking meals. That's cool. But these meals can't go to a place where people can get them. Can't the eatery be... Can't it consist of, like, a kitchen? And then, like, a big canteen? You know, like in... Prison Architect? Like, where you had the big canteen, little kitchens? Of course, the prisoners couldn't go in the kitchen unless they had to work. in the kitchen or something. But they could go to the canteen and they could just flood in there and the meals would come from the kitchen to the canteen and there was so many people that could just get meals. Whereas these dumb eateries, two people can eat. And if one of them's drinking, or both are drinking, heaven forbid, no one can eat. Unless there's magically raw food here, which maybe that'll be three. They've already used all the raw food here. I can't be 100% sure that the farms even work, although we will check. We will definitely check. They're about ready to be harvested. So, here's, crossing fingers that this actually works. Because if so, that's a good amount of food. And then the kitchen wouldn't be so much of a problem, because it would probably stock itself to full, and then the rest of the food would just be sitting here at the farm, so the people could eat it if they can't get a meal, because how are they going to get a meal? What am I supposed to do? Build 10 eateries? Just so that all my 20 nuggets can actually sit in the seat? That is bullshit. No, I don't want to do that. The eatery should have more than one table. Maybe it should evolve over time as you have more nuggets. But I don't know. I mean, there seems to be more slots, I believe. Yeah, there's lots more slots. Why can we not upgrade the eatery yet? Like, it's terrible. The first eatery was big. It was giant. It was an eyesore. But it had, like, three tables. It was so much better than this dinky piece of shit. It's horrible. Oh, he's moving to the farm. Is this you? Are you going to the farm? Yeah, you are. Oh, he's going to harvest those man-bro fruits. Do it, buddy. You can do this. I believe in you. In fact, how do you do that again? I can't remember how to... Oh, there we go. Yeah, you just click on that. We're going to watch him harvest. And let's see if that number goes up. Shall we? That was really fast, too. Like, that was really good. I thought you could only plant in spring and, like, have one harvest a year. They may have changed that. That's pretty interesting. I'm just hoping it works. Like I said, the last time I did this, I watched him harvest and I was so excited because I'm like, oh, the raw food is gonna come in. And then he was done harvesting and I got no food added. Let's see what happens. Well, there's no food yet. But that was only half the harvest, so maybe... Wait! I saw food. Right? Yeah, food! It's working! Hooray! So now all these people that are, like, starving can come and get some raw food. Because, you know, their chances of eating at the eatery are very slim. And like I said, what else are we supposed to do? You can't build, like, just a part of the eatery where people can just get their food at the eatery and then go to a table. Like, you can't build a thing that has, like, five tables or whatnot. Where you could just put it somewhere else. That would be really cool, though. Then they could go to the eatery, and really special people could eat at the eatery at that one VIP table or whatnot. And then, oh, shit, I think they took it all and put it in the eatery. I bet they did. Of course. All 13 raw food in the eatery. Nobody can eat it. And there's no way to stop them from collecting food. You can't click this. You can't tell them, do not collect food anymore. You don't need to. Why are you taking all the raw food when there's already 15 meals? Why would you do this? I mean, I understand that people don't get hungry as often. But two seats, one table for 24 nuggets, and you will notice that we actually do have double digits of nuggets. And so I think we are building a thriving city. And So far, I don't think anybody's died. How do we have them? Oh, 57. I wonder if they did something about the death. They might be reworking the death because there's not a single death yet. Which is great. Why are you guys not picking up this wood at all? This has been here since the beginning of the game, I think. And see, this is why I hate the warehouses. Like, stuff just sits here. They never lose this, ever. It doesn't even matter if you build a building, or if you build, like, a ton of buildings. They never, ever use it. Put that there. Let's see, what else do we not have? We don't have a cemetery, but I'm not gonna worry about that right now. Funeral pyre, eatery, well. Dun-da-da, we got that. We got a warehouse. We don't have a reservoir, but I don't think we need it. They're useless. That's pretty much it. Just the forecast tower, pretty much. Alright, alright. I'm cool with that. So it seems like it is possible to build a thriving city now. Now, there are still incredibly annoying behaviors. What the hell is this person doing? What are you doing? Moving to the farm. Delivering resources. What are you delivering them with? Oh, that was your head. Oh, okay. I thought he was, like, carrying something weirdly, but it was his head bobbing up and down. Okay, I see. They're building the forecast tower. Cool. So there are still incredibly things to gripe about, or a couple things to incredibly gripe about, like the fishers not becoming normal nuggets during the winter. That's annoying. That needs to be changed. The most critical thing that needs to be changed is engineers. They need to know when there are buildings that are in danger. And they need to prioritize those buildings above all else. It doesn't even matter if there's, like, because they went and they repaired the well, they went and repaired this, repaired that, because it's all around a vicinity of the engineers. And then they finally get to the ones that are broken down. Which is just not cool. This is the witch doctor, he's like super hungry, you better be going to eat. Yep, you are, girl. God, they're so freaking slow, too. Look how slow they move. It takes them so long just to get to wherever they need to go. It is interesting there's only one injured person, and she's rather healthy, honestly. Is there any... Well, there is herbs. That's good. There is no stockpile of medicines, unfortunately. There needs to be a better way of getting herbs. I can't believe they made the herbs mountain, and what was the other one? Stone? Like, why did you change the juicy acorn? Why do you break, why do you change things, or fix things that aren't broken? The juicy acorns were awesome. Why put them in the mountains? People want to build a civilization here. We don't want to be super punished for, you know, having to plant herbs. Planted, waiting for spring. Oh, fudge. It's already planted. Dang it. But now it says it's waiting for spring. Somebody injured themselves. Great. Why is this person starving? Oh, right. I know why they're starving. Probably because all the raw food is over here. Maybe it would make sense if there was a certain code in the game, a certain line of code, that made it so that nuggets always kept this full. So just in case people can't get... Because look, the eatery's full. These guys are eating. They are taking forever to eat. Other people are starving because there's no raw food to eat. See? They keep wanting to eat. There's no raw food that they can access. Even though we have 18 raw food, It's all stored in the eatery. All of it. And there's no way to take it out. There's nothing you can do. I don't even think you could destroy this and get the raw food back. And Nuggets can't access the raw food at all. Another way they could do this is maybe just have the ability to have some of this raw food out. Like a salad bar. Salads are raw. You know, maybe they could do like a salad bar where Nuggets could come and get some salad. Because this isn't fair. Like, look at this person just starving to death. Just starving to death. They're going to eat now because the tables are finally open. But like I said, what am I supposed to do? Build 30 eateries now? Well, actually, it'd be 15 eateries. I don't want to do that. I mean, that would be eateries all over the place. It would be enough seats for the current amount of Nuggets. By the time the 15 eateries were built, I would have, you know, 10 more Nuggets, probably. It does seem like death might be a thing of the past right now. Let's go ahead and assign a Nugget to be our weather caster. I didn't have a problem with the death too much. I mean, I thought it was a little overpowered for sure. Maybe they took it out so they can rebalance it. But, I mean, there's still a lot of things that Nuggets need to do. One, Nuggets need to prioritize these piles of resources. They're just sitting here. They destroy all these resources, they leave the piles, and they almost never use them. The warehouses, they just sit here. They never, ever, as far as I know, they never, ever come and grab this. At all. Just ever. What are you doing, farmer? You're doing nothing. Your health is looking terrible. Why is that? Wait, what? It's his energy. It's not his health. Never mind. This person is going to die. Yeah, look at that. 0-0. And like I said, you know why? Eatery. I'm half tempted to just stop building eateries. Because eateries are the reason why your people die. I mean, look at this. She's completely dead. And it's all because of the eatery. It is the eatery's fault. Because there's 19 raw food that's all stored in the eatery. So if I didn't have an eatery, that would be 19 raw food that anybody that was hungry could go and get. And now she's just drinking. And let me guess, she's gonna have to walk out of the eatery to try and eat, right? She can't just grab something at the eatery since she's there right now. Yeah, see? She'll have to walk out, take a little bit of time, figure out she wants to eat, go back to the eatery, and get some food. Right? Is she not gonna eat? Yeah, she's just not fucking eating. What the hell is wrong with you? There's meals. Why are you not eating? And now she's going to chop. Because she's like, I can't eat. I don't understand why you can't eat. There's 8 meals. There is no goddamn reason you can't eat. The table is free. And there's 8 meals. You could eat. Oh my god. Well, anyway, we're going to end this video before she actually does die because, you know, she is going to die. Yeah, she's very close to dying. Anyway, so there is still alpha problems, like I said. They need to be able to pick up these resources. They just litter the map. I don't want to build 40 goddamn warehouses that they're never going to use. Why? Just so it looks nicer? Great. Well, what about the resources? Why don't they use them? Why don't they prioritize picking up all this shit before they go and get the natural resources? It takes forever for them to collect the natural resources. It takes literally a second to collect the shit and use it for the resources. And now she's dead. That is not my fault. This table was clear and there were meals in the kitchen. You saw that. And she tried, like, 8 times to eat at the kitchen, and for some reason she just couldn't do it. I don't know why. I don't understand what was keeping her from doing it. It's probably because she was just too starving. But yeah, I might come back with another video and just do like an eatery only, or eatery, no eatery challenge. Because that actually sounds like the only way you can build a thriving civilization anymore. Because the eatery just gluttonizes all the food. All the raw food. 13, 12 raw food, all in the eatery. No one can ever have access to it, ever. Because it just never comes out. So yeah, I'll probably do one more video where I'm just not going to have the eatery, because I am really, really pissed off at the eatery now. I thought it was great before, but it is really being a huge problem now. So anyway, I hope you guys did enjoy it. If you did, go ahead and leave a like, it does help out a lot. Subscribe if you want to see more, share, comment, do whatever you see fit, and I will see you guys in the next video. Vidavis out.